Hey guys, Jake from 8020 Media here. Today we are continuing with our Duramax engine series and we are covering the Duramax LBZ. The Duramax LBZ was the shortest-lived Duramax, having been produced from 2006 through midway of 2007. It was built off of the 2006 Duramax LLY, which received a number of big updates over the earlier model LLYs. Compared to the earlier model LLYs, the LBZ got a thicker block, stronger rods, a larger turbo inlet, which fixed a lot of the issues with overheating and head gasket failure. The one caveat is that from an internal standpoint, the pistons got weaker, which we will talk about as a problem on our list. However, the Duramax LBZ is probably the most desirable Duramax engine out there, both for reliability and for performance modifications. The LBZ is considered one of the last pre-emissions diesel engines. It does have exhaust gas recirculation. However, it doesn't have any of the newer modern day emission systems. And so that's another factor that makes this a highly desirable and popular Duramax engine. That being said, there are a couple problems as there are with any engine. So we'll go ahead and jump into those. The first problem is really only a problem for modified engines, and that's cracked pistons. As I mentioned, the engine got a lot stronger. The power limits are a lot higher than they were on the LLY. The one caveat is that the pistons are the weak point of this engine. The pistons can handle about 600 wheel horsepower. 650 is thought to be about the maximum before you run into issues with pistons cracking. However, we would caution you going past the 600 mark without thinking about upgrading them. There are some thoughts that the issues with the pistons are caused by a manufacturing defect, just because there are cases of the pistons cracking even at stock power levels. So this is mostly a problem for tuned and heavily modified LBZs, but with that being said, there are some that have been stock or running very few modifications that have experienced this issue. The thing I'd say here is that it's not something I'd be concerned about on a stock truck or one that's running low modifications. It's only something to think about if you're really pushing that 600 plus mark, which by the time you get there, you're looking at a built trans, an upgraded turbo, lift pumps, injectors, and a number of other fueling and supporting modifications. You're going to be pretty deep into the engine and upgrades by that point. So looking at upgrading the piston shouldn't be as big of a problem if you're shooting for those power levels. Jumping into the second problem is water pump failure. The LBZ got a water pump that has a plastic impeller inside of it. And any water pump that has a plastic impeller is known to fail. The impeller essentially wears down, it stops working, and the impeller is what actually causes the coolant to flow through the engine. When that happens, coolant stops flowing through the engine, the pump fails, and you run into issues with overheating. The water pump is known to fail about every 100,000 miles on the LBZ simply because of this plastic impeller. So it is common when this pump fails to go ahead and upgrade and to get something that has an aluminum or a billet or some type of metal impeller within it. The third common problem on our list is with the transmission lines. The transmission lines have an inherent design flaw. They're responsible for flowing coolant throughout the transmission to keep transmission temperatures down. And there is a design flaw at one section of the transmission lines, which everyone calls the crimp. And at the crimp, it is known to leak transmission coolant. On some engines, this only happens when the engine's cold and then the leak stops once the engine and the transmission warm up. However, it eventually leads to a consistent leak. Every 20 to 30,000 miles, these transmission lines, at least the OEM lines, are known to go bad and start leaking. Once yours does start leaking, we recommend looking at upgraded transmission lines, since that should mitigate any issues with the transmission coolant lines leaking. Continuing down the list, our fourth problem is with the EGR system. The EGR cooler is actually very reliable. There's not really any problems with it until you get to very high mileage, at which point that becomes a maintenance item. But the EGR valve is somewhat more problematic. The valve gets gunked up over time and it can cause it to either stick closed or stick open. The one caveat here is that a lot of LBZs are already deleted at this point, but if you have an emissions compliant LBZ, you might possibly run into issues with the EGR once you start getting into that higher mileage range. It's typically not a problem on lower mileage engines just because it does take a amount of time for the EGR valve to gunk up with all of the diesel soot that's getting passed through it, through the dirty exhaust gas that gets recirculated into the engine. And then the last problem on our list is just something I'm going to mention. It's not really a huge problem, but the turbocharger vanes are known to stick from time to time. When this happens, all you have to do is pull the turbocharger off the car, give it a good cleaning, and then it should be good to go. This is a similar problem as to what you run into on the 6.0 Power Stroke. However, it's a lot less common on the LBZ. That wraps it up for our problems. Ticking down the list here, cracked pistons are only a problem really if you are running heavy modifications. Turbo vanes, not really that big of an issue. And so when we do look at things that I would call actual problems with this engine, it's the water pump, the transmission cooler lines, and then a little bit the EGR once you start getting to higher mileage. When you break down these problems, a water pump's not that big of a deal. Transmission cooler lines can be replaced pretty easily and cheaply as well. And, you know, EGR is more so a maintenance item once you start getting to higher mileage. The LBZ really does not have that many problems at all, especially when it's kept stock. You really only run into issues once you start trying to throw a lot of power at it. When you look at the reliability of the LBZ, as well as the tunability of it, that's really why this is considered the best Duramax engine out there, or the most desirable Duramax engine, especially factoring in the lack of modern emission systems that are in it. Overall, very tuner-friendly engine, very reliable engine, gets a really good reputation for reliability, and is certainly one of our favorite Duramax engines out there. That wraps things up for our problems video on the LBZ. This was nice and short because there aren't that many problems, and it's a great engine. So if you guys appreciate this video, go ahead and hit that like button, subscribe to the channel, and stay tuned for future Duramax content. And as always, we have an article on our website that discusses these problems in more depth as well.